My lords, our country's care system has never been under such pressure as over the last year. I'm sure noble lords are as grateful as I am to live in a country that could financially afford to step up to the challenges of the pandemic and has worked day and night to make sure everyone is treated with dignity and respect. Many countries around the world do not have our financial resources, and we are indeed very fortunate. My lords, the numbers speak for themselves. The government has made available £4.6 billion to local authorities to address pressures on local services. There's an additional £1 billion of funding available for social care in 2021-22. Public spending on adult social care services has increased in real terms in every year since 2015, reaching £18.8 billion in 2020. In 2021-2022, the government expects to provide local authorities with estimated funding of around £3 billion to help manage the impact of COVID across their services. These are very substantial numbers, my lords, but they are not just numbers. These translate into countless real people and real families getting the care they need. However, the funding system does need reform. This is indeed a complex area, and I welcome the government's proposals on improvement, which I understand will be brought forward this year. I also welcome the government's appreciation that anyone needing care should never have to sell their home to pay for it. My lords, the number of home care agencies in England has also significantly increased from 5,780 in 2010 to 10,294 in January of this year. That's almost double the number of home care agencies. According to CQC registration data, pressures on adult social care from the pandemic do not appear to be translating into significant amounts of reduced capacity or service closures. But this data, of course, should continue to be very closely monitored. We are not without challenges. Some providers of care settings designated for the discharge of COVID-positive individuals from hospitals have had difficulty securing sufficient levels of commercial insurance cover. This is why I welcome the recent ministerial statement that new arrangements will provide temporary state-backed indemnity cover for clinical negligence, employer's liability, and public liability to designated settings who have been unable to source adequate insurance cover. My lords, this has been an incredibly difficult year for all of us, but there's clear evidence of the tremendous work and effort the government has put into ensuring our care system delivers for everybody. There's always more to do, and areas where improvements must continue to be made. Finally, I would like to pay tribute to all those workers in care settings who have faced probably the most difficult year of their professional lives and have made our country so very proud.